The heart is one of the main components of the circulatory system, and its main function is to pump blood throughout the body. So we're going to go through a quick, very basic overview of blood flow throughout the body. Then we'll go through how the heart works. So we'll start at the lungs, where blood picks up oxygen. It then flows to the heart, where it gets pumped throughout the body to different organs and tissues. At the organs and tissues, blood drops off oxygen and picks up carbon dioxide. The blood then flows back to the heart, where it's pumped to the lungs. In the lungs, carbon dioxide is dropped off and oxygen is picked up, and voila, the blood has completed its cycle. And it will continue this cycle again and again and again. Now back to the heart. So the heart pumps oxygen-rich or oxygenated blood to tissues and organs, and it pumps deoxygenated blood to the lungs. Now let's take a look at the components of the heart. I'm going to list technical terms and names of various parts of the heart on the screen, but I'm going to keep the language as basic as I can. This illustration is if someone is facing us, the viewers, so right and left are going to appear backwards. The heart consists of four chambers and four valves. As you can see here, I've labeled them. There are the pulmonary arteries here, which will carry oxygen poor or deoxygenated blood from the heart to the lungs. Here are the pulmonary veins, which will carry oxygenated blood from the lungs to the heart. One note here, the arteries and veins I just mentioned are kind of backwards, in that everywhere else in the body, arteries carry oxygenated blood and veins carry deoxygenated blood. The pulmonary veins and arteries are the only exception. Next we have the aorta, which is the largest artery in the body, and it carries oxygenated blood to the upper and lower regions of the body. And the last part of our diagram is the vena cava, which transports deoxygenated blood, which I have as the color blue, from the body to the heart. So what is going to happen is these upper chambers, which I have listed as number 1 and number 3, are going to fill with blood. Chamber number 1 is going to fill with deoxygenated blood from the body, and chamber 3 is going to fill with oxygenated blood coming from the lungs. As this happens, valves A and D start to open, and blood starts to flow into chambers 2 and 4. Next, the muscles of chambers 1 and 3 are going to contract at the same time, forcing any remaining blood into chambers number 2 and 4. Then, the muscles of chambers 2 and 4 will start to contract, and this increases the pressure on the blood in the chambers. This increased pressure closes valves A and D. The muscle contraction continues, and valves B and C are forced open. The blood is then ejected from chambers 2 and 4. The blood from chamber 2 flows through valve B into the pulmonary arteries and eventually to the lungs, and the blood from chamber 4 flows through valve C into the aorta, which then sends the blood to organs and tissues. And this cycle continues. So there you have it, the basics on the components of the heart and how it functions.